Yes, good afternoon, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the wonder of the life that is regarding the fishes. Now, this is regarding the beauty of the life, beauty of the planet Earth, beauty of the ocean, where we have different varieties, types, species of the fishes. Right? Okay. So along with our textual knowledge also, along with the textbook, so what is there out of the text? How the living organisms are there? So it depends on your interest, how you look over the things keenly, clearly, that is present around us. Okay, so that's why if you really want to enjoy biology, you should not be within the four walls. You have to come out of the walls and you have to see the nature. Okay, so you can enjoy like anything. So that's why nature's beauty is the aesthetic value. Okay, so aesthetic meaning, so lot of beautiful places are there, beautiful animals are there, beautiful plants are there, flowering plants, fishes, aquatic animals are there. So that you have to see. Okay, so we have ample of species in the planet Earth. Okay, yes. So with this, as we are discussing about our syllabi, where we have came across the monerans, mainly kingdom Monera, we were discussing regarding the structure of a bacterial cell. So yesterday we have came across the structure of the bacterial cell. We try to understand the parts of a bacterial cell. Then we came across different types of bacteria based on the shapes. Okay, Bhagya. So diagram has been shown yesterday, and I told you whenever we go through the class, take a screenshot. Okay, and now if you want those, don't post all the screenshots in the group. Okay, because you lose the link. The link will go to a very larger extent where you cannot find the link also. So that's why. So whoever wants, send them personally to their WhatsApp group. So need not post all the snapshots in the group. Okay, fine. Yes. Okay, fine. Srishti, yesterday's class video has been over yesterday only. Okay, if you want to see it, it will be on my status. You can see it there. Okay, right. Yes. Now, if you are not taken it, it will be on my status, WhatsApp status, later on after this class at 4 o'clock. You can see it. Okay, right. So let me continue with the next part of it. Now here we are coming across the types of bacteria. In the type, the first one we are going to discuss regarding archaea bacteria. Then the second part we are moving across the eubacteria. Now, as we know regarding the archaea bacteria are those microbes, are those bacteria which are present in harsh environmental condition. Harsh environmental conditions. So archaea bacteria are those bacteria where they are present in harsh environmental condition. Harsh meaning where none of the other organisms can survive, in that climate they can survive. Yava jagadalli yava pradeshadalli bere jeevigalige badaklikke anukoola iruvanta vatavarana irangilla anta environment olagade aa vatavarana olagade badukuvanta jeevigalu ivu yavu archaea bacteria. So they can survive under harsh environmental condition. Harsh meaning which is unfavorable, unsuitable environment for the live other organisms that can survive, sustain, lead their life. Yes. Okay. Now, Archaebacteria, if we look at their types, again, these are of three types. Yes. What are these? The first one is thermoacidophiles. Then second one, methanogens. And third one, halophiles. Yes. So how many types are there? There are three different types of the Archaebacteria. Archae meaning old. Yes. Archae meaning old bacteria, where they can survive under harsh environmental conditions. And they are present on this earth from millions, billions of years ago. Yes. Because earth has been originated over more than 4.5 billion years back. From that, after the origin of the earth, some of the microorganisms that got originated were the older, olden type of bacteria, older type of bacteria, where we say it as, where we call it as Archaebacteria. Yes. Okay. Harsh environmental example. Harsh means we are discussing the same thing here. Yes. We are discussing the harsh environmental condition here only. So let us see these. Now here we have thermoacidophiles. What do we mean by thermoacidophiles? Now thermoacidophiles meaning the organisms that can survive at high temperature. The bacteria that can survive at higher temperature. Yes. Or we also call this as, we also use one more term called as hot springs. Hot springs at a temperature of about 80 to 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, at a temperature of about 80 to 100 degrees Celsius. Such type of organisms that can grow at a high temperature of 80 to 100 degrees Celsius in the hot springs, even in the volcanic eruptions also, such type of organisms are said to be thermoacidophiles. Thermo, Vishal, desert alla. Desert daga 80 temperature 80 degrees Celsius yav kalku hoyangilla. Alli 80 degree hoytandre yav praninu badakangilla. Yes, desert ogade as temperature irangilla. Desert olagade iruvanta temperature as 50 to 55 degrees Celsius. At the most, it may go up to 57, 58 degrees Celsius. It does not go beyond that. Yes? Okay. But hot springs, meaning thermal vents. We also call it as thermal vents. Geyser olagade irthav. Geyser olagade temperature. Yes, irthada. Water boils at what degree Celsius? Where it converts from liquid to gaseous state. 100 degrees Celsius. Okay? Yes. Okay. Now, in the thermoacidophiles, we have example, and that example is Thermococcus. Thermococcus bacteria, okay, which can sustain, survive at a high temperature of 100 degrees Celsius, okay, where none of the organism can survive. And you can take an example of the humans. Now, can we survive at higher temperature? Usually in our area, at the summer season, if you look at the temperature, what will be the temperature? Hardly it will be around 38, 39, 42 maximum. In Bijapur, it may go up to 41. And in case of the Bidar, Gulbarga, Raichur there, the temperature will go up to 42, 43 degrees Celsius. Okay. In Delhi, the temperature goes up to 45 degrees Celsius. Okay, we cannot tolerate the heat of even 40 degrees Celsius. Okay, nam environmental condition 40 to 41 degree hoytu antadre nam tadukolak agilla. ಓಕೆ ಆ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಟಾಲರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳಕ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ 80 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಆಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಎ ಹಾಟ್ ಓವನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನಾಟ್ ಟಾಲರೇಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಆದಿತ್ಯ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ 49 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಸಿಟಿ ಎಸ್ 49 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್ ಈವನ್ ಡೆಸರ್ಟ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ರಾಜಸ್ಥಾನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ದಟ್ ಅಂತಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನಾಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಸಿಟಿ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೋಕ್ ಎಸ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಹೈಡ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಗಂಗಾನಗರ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಅಷ್ಟು ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಹೋದಾಗ ನೋ ಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಮರ್ ಸೀಸನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಟಾಲರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೊ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಟಾಲರೇಟ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಅಟ್ ಎ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ 45 ಡಿಗ್ರೀಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಬಿ ಡೆತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಏಜ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಯಸ್ಸಾದವರು ಸಾಯ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಹೈ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಗೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾಕೆ ಡೆತ್ ಆಗ್ತದ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಡಿಗ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಗ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಬಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಥರ್ಮೋಸಿಡೋಫೈಲ್ಸ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಸ್ಟೈನ್ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಅಟ್ ಎ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ 100 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್ ದೇ ಹಾವ್ ಎ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿತ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹೈ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಸಚ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಥರ್ಮೋಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಅವ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಥರ್ಮೋಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಎಂಜೈಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಓಕೆ ಚೈತ್ರ 60 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಇನ್ ಗಂಗಾನಗರ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ನೀವು ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತಾವ ಓಕೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೂ ಯು ನೋ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರಾಜ್ಯ ನಾವು ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಸ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನ್ ಐಡಿಯಲ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇವನ್ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ನೀವು ನೆರೆ ರಾಜ್ಯ ಹೋಗ್ರಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಆಂಧ್ರ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಬಹಳ ಸಿವಿಯರ್ ಇರತ್ತೆ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೋಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೋಸ್ ಸಿಟೀಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕೂಲರ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ ಬೆಲ್ಗಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿಟಿ ವೇರ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಮ್ ಕೂಲ್ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಇರ್ತದ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಲಕ್ಕಿ ಇನಫ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಬರ್ತ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಎಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಅರ್ಪಿತಾ ಎಸ್ ವಿಕಾಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಮೂರ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಚಂದ ಜಮ್ಗಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ಎಸ್ ಪ್ರಜ್ವಲ್ ನೌ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಸಸ್ಟೈನ್ ವಿ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ದೇರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಸೌದಿ ಅರೇಬಿಯಾಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಬರೀ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಹೆಂಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದೆ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಹಾಟ್ ಅನ್ಬೇರೇಬಲ್ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಟಾಲರೇಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಂಗಿದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದ ಜನ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಬದುಕ್ತಾರೆ ಎ ಸಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಆಫೀಸ್ಗೆ ಹೋದ್ರು ಎ ಸಿ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಕಾರ್ನಾಗೂ ಎ ಸಿ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋದ್ರೂ ಎ ಸಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬದುಕ್ತಾರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ದೇ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಓಕೆ ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವೈವಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೂ ಲೋ ದೇರ್ ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಥರ್ಮೋಸಿಡೋಫೈಲ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಮಿಥನೋಜನ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ದ ನೇಮ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಮಿಥನೋಜನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಏರಿಯಾಸ್ these are present in marshy areas so methanogens are those which are present in marshy areas okay that means marshy what does the term marshy refers to where moisture content along with the acidic medium is there these bacteria can survive in high acidic conditions yes humid will be there and the condition will be acidic okay acidic antara where the ph is very very less say about the ph might be 1 to 2 highly acidic and karidivi it's very highly acidic as you know the ph scale ph 7 is said to be neutral the ph of the water is neutral suppose if you take the soap water ph is alkaline above 7 and if you take the tea or a coffee its ph is slightly acidic okay around it will be a 5.5 ph irthada so marshy means where the area consists of moisture and it is acidic water content irthada it is acidic medium irthada acidic medium dage yav organism badakangilla yes one fishes cannot live there yes that is acidic highly acidic let us say highly acidic so marshy areas methanogens are those where they can survive in marshy areas, right? And here it's a highly acidic condition. If we take out the examples, example for this is Mycobacterium. Yes, it is a Mycobacterium. Example for this Mycogen is Mycobacterium. Yes, Mycococcus. Right, both are correct. Mycococcus or Mycobacterium. Okay, so this is Mycogens. So in the marshy areas, none of the other organisms can survive, but still these can survive. Mycogens are also most important because they are going to produce which gas? They are responsible for the production of biogas. Yes, Mycogens means methane producing bacteria, which are responsible for the production of biogas. Yes, okay. Right, then next we'll go across the halophiles. Halophiles are those where the animals, not animals, these microbes, bacteria are present in high salty conditions. Okay, so hypersaline condition. Yes, they are present in high salty regions. Hypersaline condition. Hypersaline, salt concentration jasti irodha. Okay, I will give you an example. Now, I hope most of you have visited the seashores. Okay, nearby seashores. Either it might be the Murdeshwar coastal area, or it might be Gokarna, it might be a Goa belt. So whichever it might be, Mangalore belt. Okay, either it might be towards the Arabian Sea, or towards the Bay of Bengal, or whichever, Indian Ocean. Okay, yes, you have visited. Now, when you enter into the sea, then have you tasted the water? Samudra neer yavattadru taste madidiri? Have you tasted it? Okay, no. Allu hogade iddavaru anivarya, hodavaru. At least you have to taste it once. Taste andre kudibekanta enilla, bai hak nodbekagutte. Correct? ಹೆಂಗಿರ್ತದ ವೆರಿ ಸಾಲ್ಟಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈ ಸಮುದ್ರ ನೀರನ್ನು ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಸಾಲ್ಟಿ ಅಂತ ಅನಿಸ್ತಿರ್ತದೆ ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹಾಲೋಫೈಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತಾರ ಹೈ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಹೈಪರ್ ಸಲೈನ್ ಅದು ಹೆಂಗಿರ್ತದ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಎ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫುಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಅದು ಬರೇ ಉಪ್ಪು ನೀರಲ್ಲ ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಉಪ್ಪು ಓಕೆ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ Let us call it as 100% salty. So here it is 100% salty condition. That means it's you cannot imagine the taste also. Astu ketta. Okay, samudra neera namu bai olagade haaklikka angilla astu salty irutade. Here halophiles they can survive at a very high salty areas, high salty condition. That's why the name halophiles, hypersaline conditions. They can survive in this. That means these are the three different types of the bacteria where we say them as archaebacteria, and these can survive in this harsh environmental condition where none of the other species can survive. Yes, where other species can't survive in that area, if these survive, then only we call them as what? We call them as archaebacteria. Yes, for the halophiles we have an example called as a Halococcus. Okay, Halococcus. So that's an example for it, right? So this is regarding the archaebacteria and their types. Okay, if you want, you can take the snapshot here. Yes, take the snapshot again. Don't ask it tomorrow. Yes, right. Okay. So if you want the explanation, okay. In a single statement, I will explain you. Okay, listen it carefully. Thermoacidophiles, as the name says, thermometer. Connected to the temperature, the bacteria that can sustain high temperatures, the bacteria that can survive in hot springs, the bacteria which are present in the thermal vents are said to be thermoacidophiles, where they can survive at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius. these bacteria are not killed at 100 degrees Celsius. They are killed above 100 degrees Celsius. Okay. Then second one is methanogens. Methanogens are the bacteria that are present in the marshy areas where the condition is highly acidic, more acidic with moisture, And methanogens, we have an example called as methanobacterium, which is responsible for the production of the biogas, which is also called as gobar gas. Okay, with the help of the cow dung, tono biogas production maadthivu halli olagade irthadiku alli iruvanta bacteria methanogens. Okay, then halophiles are those bacteria which are present in high salt concentration, hyper saline areas, right, where the salt concentration is 100% salt. Okay, suppose if the seawater salt concentration is around 35%, then here hyper saline areas salt concentration is 100%, highly concentrated. Okay, yes, so this is regarding the Prasad, Halobacterium or Halococcus, they are spherical bacteria. So this is regarding the three different types. Okay, right, so let's move to the next one. Let me quote a few example of Eubacteria. We have came across the Archaebacteria. Next one comes the Eubacteria. Archaebacteria are those bacteria which are present in harsh environmental condition, while Eubacteria, they are said to be true bacteria. Then the question comes, why do we call them as a true bacteria? This is because they can survive only under normal environmental conditions, while these Archaebacteria that you are seeing it on the screen, they are present in harsh environmental condition. This is because of the cell wall, which is highly rigid, that can withstand high temperature, high acidic mediums, high salt concentration. The cell wall is modified in such a way, and they have certain enzymes where they can tolerate these harsh environmental conditions. While these bacteria, where we call them as Eubacteria or the true bacteria, these bacteria, they cannot survive at, these Eubacteria do not survive at what harsh environmental conditions, while they can survive only during optimal conditions. Where other organisms can survive, there these bacteria will survive. Andre yav bere jagadalli bere jeevigalu badukthava anta jagadalli ee Eubacteria galu badukirthavu. That's why we call them as true bacteria. True bacteria hangidra Archaebacteria false bacteria endre ent kelabodu alla eradu bacteria na adan yak aa reethi navu classify maadidivu antadra avu iruvanta vasisanta sthalagalu. Okay, where exactly they are present, so based on that we are classifying the microorganisms. Yes, okay. Now these Eubacteria, almost here we have the autotrophic also, heterotrophic also. So let me quote few examples here. For example, we are quoting across an example called as for this Eubacteria, Cyanobacteria. Yes, we are quoting across Cyanobacteria. And almost Prajwal, Kannada meaning of true bacteria. Bacteria galu Kannada dagi enantu karitipa? Bacteria antana karitarala? Or is there any other word for this? Okay, now here Cyanobacteria, as the name says, bluish color appearance of this bacteria. Mainly in this Cyanobacteria we come across a nostoc. This nostoc is also said to be a PGA, blue green algae. Now nostoc is a bacteria which is filamentous, so generally it is filamentous, so it appears in this way. ಇದು ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇವು ಒಂದೊಂದು ಏನು ನಾವು ತೆಗಿತೀವಿ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ yes these are the bacteria now here what we have is on its outer part it is having a mucilage layer ili mucilage layer mucilage means jelly okay the jelly layer where we call it as a mucilage layer okay then here we have a particular type of cells okay now this is the bacterial cell this is the mucilage layer these are said to be heterocyst Now, this is the structure of a nostril. This is structure of a nostril, which is commonly called as BGA. Then, what is this BGA? BGA means blue-green algae. Okay, blue-green algae. BGA meaning blue-green algae. Now, blue-green algae. ಇವು ಅಲ್ಗೆ ತರ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರ ಅಲ್ಗೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗತ್ತೆ ಪಾಚಿಗಳು ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಎಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ನಾವು ಕಪಿ ಮಾಸ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ನಿವೇದಿತ ವೇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಯು ಓಕೆ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಹೆಟ್ರೋಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಬ್ಲೂ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಅಲ್ಗೆ ರೀತಿ ಹೋಲೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಕಾಣಿಸೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಈ ನಾಸ್ಟಾಟ್ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಕಾಮನ್ ಆಗಿ ಬ್ಲೂ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಅಲ್ಗೆ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಓಕೆ Now each one represents a cell here. Now here this is one cell, this is one more cell, this is the third cell, fourth cell. So these are the cells, and they are attached to each other, and they form into a filament-like structure. So that's why it is called as filamentous. Now start this filamentous cell theory. So it is filamentous elongated structure and theory. So that's why filamentous microbe. Now it is surrounded by a mucilage layer one jelly layers surround agirthada that is for the protection then here we have the structure called as heterocyst the function of the heterocyst is it fixes atmospheric nitrogen and this atmospheric nitrogen is fixed by the heterocyst cells and Hence, this is present in the paddy fields. ಭತ್ತದ ಗದ್ದೆ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇರತ್ತಿದ that will enrich the fertility of the soil. Thereby, the paddy plants they will get atmospheric nitrogen because as it is present in water, in the paddy fields also we find water. So it helps in fixation of atmospheric nitrogen, right? So that is a major function of the heterocyst, right? So this is one example of cyanobacteria. Other examples are also there. Yes, other examples are also there here. We can take one more example of a bacteria called as a lactobacillus. You know regarding the lactobacillus. Other example, let us quote here. Other example is lactobacillus. This is also called as a LAB. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಹೆಸರು ಎಲ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಿ ಆರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಸಿಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಚಂದ್ರಶೇಖರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೋಬ್ಯಾಸಿಲಸ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಡೇ ಟು ಡೇ ಲೈಫ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕರ್ಡ್ ಓಕೆ ನೌ ಕರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಕರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಚಕ್ಸ್ ದ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಕಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಯಾಥೋಜನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಸ್ಟಮಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಟೆಸ್ಟೈನ್ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಬೇರೆ ಮೈಕ್ರೋ ಆರ್ಗನಿಸಮ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ವು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ನು ಕಿಲ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ ಗಟ್ ರೀಜನ್ ದಾಗ ಎರಡನೇ ಬೆನಿಫಿಷಿಯಲ್ ರೂಲ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ಸ್ ವಿಟಮಿನ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ವೆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಯಾವುದು ಕರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿಟಮಿನ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ವೆಲ್ and that vitamin B12 is very much essential for the normal functioning of our neural system, nervous system. Nam nerve cells active edutadu. That's why curd is very good for health. Okay, so if you are consuming curd every day, a cup of curd, then it's very good for health. Okay, na helidana antanda bahalasta 1 liter gantle mosru kudidiri matti ivattu. Okay, no, don't do like that. Okay, a cup of curd, that too, it's a it should be good quality. Okay, good quality curd and correctly, it should not be sorry bahalu huli irbaru anta mosru tinbaru yakandre all over fermentation aagidaru bacteria. Okay, yes, Shivlila, yes, mycoplasma is the smallest bacteria and it is a Wallace prokaryote. Yes, as you have quoted it, so let me quote here. Yes, mycoplasma as Shivlila has taken this name. Yes, mycoplasma, this is the smallest and Wallace prokaryote. This is the smallest and Wallace andre cell wall irangilla. Okay, which is the smallest bacteria and kedaga mycoplasma. Yes, it is the mycoplasma. Yes, now bacteria, they also causes disease in the humans. Yavudadru one example helthiri. Bacterial disease of human, namage disease cause madantada. Anyone example? Correct. Gonorrhea, bacterial disease. Cholera, bacterial disease. Correct. Yes, so gonorrhea is caused by Neisseria gonorrhea. Cholera is caused by Vibrio cholerae. Yes, syphilis is caused by Treponema pallidum. Malaria, bacterial disease alla. Malaria, bacterial disease alla. Yes, okay. Typhoid, very good. Nandu, typhoid, Salmonella typhi. Typhoid is caused by Salmonella typhi. We know that HIV alla virus alla. Yes, ringworm alla. Corona virus alla. Yes, correct. Yes. Genital warts, genital herpes, adeno bacterial disease, viral disease, viral disease adu. Plasmodium alla, adu plasmodium is a protozoan parasite, bacteria alla. Yes, malaria alla, plasmodium. Yes, Rishikesh, plague, bacterial disease. Yes, okay, fine. So citrus canker, correct. Tetanus is there, somewhat very good. Yes, okay, fine, all are correct. Okay, most of you have given the right answer for this. Okay, so we require only this part here. That means these bacteria are going to cause disease and some are useful bacteria. That means in the bacteria we have both the types here, useful bacteria, harmful bacteria. Harmful bacteria causes disease in both plants as well as animals. Useful bacteria play a beneficial role. And I would like to tell you one thing. Suppose if the bacteria are not there in the nature, what could have happened? Suppose if the bacteria are not there in the nature, what could have happened? There is no decomposition. There is no formation of a new place for a new organism. Then there is no formation of any of the foodstuffs. Most of the foodstuffs that we are preparing in our house, for example, like dosa and idli, microorganism illa andra dosa nu irthirilla, idli nu irthirilla. Very good, Harsha. Mosru irta irlilla. Understood. Balasta foodstuffs are microorganisms inda now tayar maartivi. Right. So here we could have lost most of the food items, even including cheese. And in that cheese, we have a special variety called as a Swiss cheese. Yes. Okay. We could have lost all those things. Fine. Okay. So this is the beneficial role of microbes. Right. Okay. Saurabh, pizza. Yes, Shanta, cakes. Yes, definitely we require microbes, but there we are using yeast. Okay, so with this we are ending up with the first kingdom and we are moving on the second kingdom. Yes, okay, and the second kingdom is kingdom protista. Kingdom protista, that we are going to see it in the tomorrow's class. Okay, so if you want, you can take the snapshot here. So with this, let's end up the class today. There is many classes. Probably it will start on 23rd of August. Hopefully, we are eagerly waiting for to welcome you all. So you should wait for our message. Okay, so definitely we will convey all the message to you, whichever we get from the state government, from the education minister. So do not worry about all those classes. Yes, Sana, yesterday's class. Okay, yesterday's class, it will be there on my status. If you want, you can just see it there only, but every day it will not be there. Yavago ondo erado miss agirthava akirthivi, but every day pratidina adike hogutbada. Okay, so fine, good day, thank you.